So, Gammon sent me a tablet. Honestly, I've never heard of them before, but looking at their site, apparently they have a wide range of tablets. But yeah, thank you for sending me a tablet. What they have sent me here is the S630. It comes in two versions, the S630 and the S830. There are two different sizes, the 6-inch and the 8-inch. It's a battery-free pen tablet, and it's even compatible with Android phones. The price is at $32.99. Also, be sure to check them out on Facebook and Twitter. They'll hold a giveaway once they reach 1,000 followers on each site. Now let's see what's in the box. First up, we got the tablet. There's this wacky design on it. It's actually flat against the surface, and it has shortcut buttons. Here's the quick start guide. A little pouch with extra nibs, a USB-C adapter, the cord, and the pen. Next up, I gotta download the driver from their website and install it. Gonna be using that USB-C adapter because my laptop only has USB-C ports. The tablet has a light indicator to let you know that it is powered. Now to the driver. You can set your work area to a specific monitor if you have more than one. Currently I only have one. You can rotate it around if you want. You can see that the work area goes to the center of the tablet. You can see it indicated by the white dots on the tablet right here. It's so that there's more area space for you to rest your hand on. Here we have the pen pressure sensitivity adjustment. First time pressing it down, I felt the pen was quite heavy, so I adjusted the curve to go lower so when I pushed down on the pen, the strokes would be lighter. Here you can customize the buttons on the pen. And lastly, customizing the buttons on the tablet. Okay, so I'm gonna draw something to test this tablet out. On the tablet, it has this alien space-ish design on it. So I'm gonna draw something spacey. Just an astronaut, that's it. And after I've done the sketch for a bit, I kind of felt like the setting that I did on the pen pressure in the driver setting to be a little bit too light, and I had to make my brushes big in order to get a thicker line, so I went back and adjusted those settings just a bit before continuing on. Finished up the rest of the sketch. Did the lines. Moving on to coloring, I tried testing her hair color out with different colors, but I'm gonna try to keep this piece an overall bluish purple. With shading, I like to shade in gray first before changing its color later. Before I get to clean up, I like to work on the background first so I can get a sense of what the atmosphere is like before I do any more adjustments. And the final stage, my favorite part, which is to merge all the layers and then paint on top of it. Add some color effects and some stars. And it's complete. I do want to mention one problem I did run into while drawing. The pen's tip felt very stiff, and there was a squeaking sound coming out of it. I'll let you listen to this clip right here. And I thought, this isn't normal, so I should try changing the nib first. I grabbed the extra nibs that they gave, and a couple just went flying. So took that out and replaced it. Once I tested it out, it was smooth, there was no squeaking, and it was perfectly fine. Next up, I'm gonna test this out with an Android phone. I don't use Android, but I'm gonna borrow my mom's. Just plug this in with the adapter, and the indicator light comes on, so it's ready for use. No drivers need to be installed at all. Oh yeah, this is a Samsung Galaxy Note 9. You can see here the working area is just in the shape of the phone screen. It takes up only just half of the tablet. The tablet buttons on the top don't work, but clicking the buttons on the pen does bring up the phone's pen options. The pen pressure works fine, but it's kind of weird to have the phone in your hand while drawing. I feel like my hand-eye coordination is kind of off, maybe because the screen is at my left instead of directly in front of me. It's a really weird feeling, not something that I'm really liking. There's no real issue with it, but does it work? Yeah, it works pretty fine. Besides the fact that I'm not used to this, I'm more used to having my left hand on a keyboard. Okay, so final thoughts. The pen is a bit light, though you could get like those silicone caps. It'll cover up the buttons though, but personally I would find something to weigh it down a little bit. I also ended up not using any of the shortcut buttons because I'm more used to using a keyboard. I think the size is just right, like there's enough area to rest your hands at. I really like the bottom part here. I wish there was something where you could keep or hold your pen at though. It's a good size for travel if you work outside a lot, like you could connect this to your phone. Should you get this, I'd say this is good for beginners as like a my first tablet. Or if you're a hobby artist, the price is just right. If you're thinking, oh, you gotta use the big tablets, to be honest, this size works just fine, it's good enough to make art with. Thanks so much for watching, I hope you found this video useful. Be sure to follow me on Twitter, Tumblr, and Instagram. I'm also streaming on Twitch whenever I feel like it. Links in the description. That's it, bye!